Okay, so there was an example. It's getting late, pushing 1 o'clock plus in the morning at this point here. I didn't do the automatic threading, so the thread didn't take. So it'd be like having a broken thread. So the machine says, hey, wait a minute, this isn't working, let's stop. I hit OK. Now, in this event, the machine did move by, I don't know, maybe 6-8 strokes, if you would. I can hit the button on the bottom here for plus or minus in the pattern. So for example, right now, if I hit minus 10, I don't think I had 10 total strokes of the needle. It just moved back to 10, okay? If I hit negative 1, it's moving back, and it reaches a point where it doesn't go any further back because we're at the beginning of the pattern. I can also tell because look at my little, where I'm starting right here, that X is now at the very tip. It didn't come down much, but that's just a way for us to be able to get back, okay? All right, the 0 point, by the way, brought me back to center of the pattern. That might also be a way of starting from scratch. So I'll tell you what, I'm gonna go from 0 point just to see what's gonna happen here. Hit okay. And then, whoops, okay, that's 0 point. Brought us backwards. It took us to the next pattern. Now I don't want that, all right? So I need to, in other words, if I hit go right now, it's gonna go to redo the black. That's no good. So I need to move forward in my choices here. So right there was what I hit, plus and minus. When I hit 0, it was effectively the same as hitting minus up here, okay? So when I hit plus, that moved me to the triangle, which is my outer. I've already done step 1. That's gonna bring me up to the triangle, which brings me to step 2. So we are right. I hope that's helpful. Let's see if we can get back to doing some embroidering. So that touchscreen is pretty helpful. Yep, there it goes, right there in front. Cool. Moving on to our next color and next set of patterns here, which is going to be yellow. Hang on while I switch out the threads. Okay, we're ready for our last color. Now there are a couple of runner threads in here. I'm gonna cut those out just so they don't get sewn in again or catch the needle as we're going through with the brown thread. Okay, we're ready for the last step. Cut away that runner. Okay, let's see how we did. the, I want to say tricks, if you would, is to get texture by changing direction of the threads. So we can see in here, the threads are going a different direction than the ones here in the same color, but we can pick up the star back in behind here. Now there, the white coming through here, if I had a darker material backing, then it wouldn't be that big of a deal. But right now, that's just because the thread count isn't high enough. So I'm going to, I've already increased that number for your uploads. You'll have a thicker thread count throughout all of this. And we have something called compensation, thread compensation. It also keeps it so that the edges fill in, so you don't get this along the edges. This is not from the bobbin thread. This is from not enough stitches over the size of the pattern. Effectively, this is the look you might get if you took a pattern that was, say, a 3-inch pattern and then extended it on the machine out to a 4-inch pattern, okay? So in this case right now, one alternative, if I had this one right here, would be to lower the size of, and I'm just, you know, spitballing here, not making excuses. I'm not a professional at this, I'm still learning. But you know, if I was going to work with this pattern right now, I had no other choice, I would reduce the size on the brother machine, which would increase the stitch count for the size of the pattern, right? And would fill in those extra areas, most likely give you a thicker area in there, all right? So there would be one way to be able to use it for your favor. So again, I hope these patterns are helpful to you. For our current one, we can see there. We can see there. All right. Once more, if you like this video, please click the like button. If you'd like to see more uploadable patterns, free, and you're more than welcome to subscribe. And then what we'll do is we'll try to get you up to the embroidery.com links. And from there, you'll be able to download the .pes. That's the format you'll need for your Brother 600, 625. Most of the Brother embroidery machines will work with the .pes. That's the format that these are in. So I hope that's helpful. Stay well, be blessed. If there's any questions, please put them in the comments below. And I'll look forward to keep an eye out, try to get you answers. Thank you.